play Sam on the hit Nickelodeon show iCarly. Here's a clip of her in action.
Sam, Griffin. Griffin, this is my best friend, Sam.
Hi.
Sup, hot lips?
Sam. So you go to school here?
No, Bolton. I just ditched homeroom.
To come see me?
Yeah. If I go to your apartment, your brother's gonna tase me or something.
I've been tased. It's not so bad. It's actually kind of a rush.
Please welcome Jennette McCurdy. You look just beautiful.
Thank you.
Very, very, very nice dress and everything. This is exciting. This show is a huge hit on Nickelodeon.
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit about your character, because I think it's kind of fun for young girls to see. She's kind of a tomboy, right?
Yeah, definitely. Sam's like really edgy and wacky and zany. She's a co-host of iCarly. It's three kids who do a web show together. Freddie's their technical producer, and Carly and Sam run the web show together and just get to act crazy all the time, but Sam's definitely the edgy, zany one. I love playing her.
Do you ever get surprised by, I know that there's a lot of famous people with kids and they're all watch
right.
The show. What's that like for you? Have you ever run into anybody and you're like, oh my God?
Oh, I have the best story. Okay.
Uh-oh.
I was at the premiere for Monsters vs. Aliens, right? And there was a red carpet and of course Reese Witherspoon was there. She looked amazing.
Who?
Reese Witherspoon.
Oh, wow.
She's one of my idols. See, in this picture, I look like a total dork. My
jaw
looks like it was punched or something, but I figured it out. I think I was saying something to Reese Witherspoon. I think I was like, I love you, through the picture, and that's why my face is like turned all odd like that.
No, I think that you look like you could be sisters in that photograph.
She looks great and me not so much, but that's
okay. No, don't say that. You look beautiful. Believe in yourself, right? Oh, no, you weren't. Do you drink coffee?
No. People say I'm like the Energizer Bunny. I keep going and going and going.
Well, and so is that your personality just lended itself to be an actor? I mean, were you always, like, when you were a little kid wanting to do this? How did it all start? Because you're so young.
No, I was way shy when I was really little. There was a couple years of my life when
way
you
shy.
Seriously, you wouldn't even find a picture of me. I would turn my head so you'd just see like this blonde puff of like, I had a little blonde afro. It was like a little blonde afro.
Aww.
And that's all you'd see. I started because when I was really little, my mom actually had breast cancer, mm-hmm. and she was in the hospital for just months on end, and I have three older brothers. So me and my three older brothers would watch the original Star Wars movies to try and take our minds off of things, and
right.
we'd always say, oh, mommy has the Force, mommy has the Force, and I particularly looked up to Han Solo. Loved Harrison Ford. Just saying. He was pretty cool.
Yes.
I had a big crush on him.
Me too.
Yeah.
I'm with you on that one.
All right. High five. Han Solo.
Han Solo all the way.
And, then my mom eventually recovered. It's been 14 years now.
Cancer-free. Yeah, I know. Your mom's doing great.
And Star Wars Episode 1 came out on the big screen, and I loved it so much. As soon as the credits started rolling, I said, Mommy, I want to be in the movies like Han Solo. He wasn't even in the movie, but I still loved him so much. And I started because I wanted to be in the next Star Wars movie. That didn't happen, but...
There's still time. There's still time.
Is there any other Star Wars thing coming?
There might be. There might be. And if there's any kids at home watching that might have a scary situation with a mom or a dad being mm-hmm. sick, it really is important to keep the faith, right?
Yeah, definitely. Mm-hmm. Definitely.
How did you get through it? Besides, you know, you had the love of your brothers and watching the movies and everything.
Yeah.
It must have been tough at times.
Yeah,
right?
My mom was so strong, too, through it all. I don't even know. She's the strongest person I know. She just, when she was always in the hospital, she would try to make it a good experience for me and my older brothers because we were having a hard time with it, too. It's really hard on the whole family. And she would make us little goodie bags and fill it with little trinkets so that every time we went to the hospital, we would get something good and we wouldn't be so sad about it.
Isn't that nice?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and I know that this has had a big influence on the development of your own character in real life, which
yeah.
I think is really important because you do give back. You have this new song out, right? Very nice. It's beautiful. And I know some of the proceeds, why don't you tell our audience how you're paying it forward?
Yeah, I actually was so fortunate to have met this little boy named Cody Waters, who was 9 years old, and he had brain cancer, and I just loved him like a little brother. I loved him more than mm-hmm. I could imagine loving anybody. He was the sweetest, strongest, he and my mom were the strongest people I've ever met, and he always was optimistic and always smiled, and anybody who came up to him, he asked how they were feeling, and sincerely cared about everybody else in the world, and was the most selfless person ever, and I was so touched by him, and then he actually passed away. And it was just so hard on me, and I miss him so much. But 20% of the proceeds are going to the Cody Waters Foundation, right, which is for him.
I think it's interesting because I know you come out here with a lot of energy, and I think something that's really important to you is to bring a lot of joy to people, because you've experienced so much heartache, and even though you're very, very young, you've had a lot of challenges. And I think the good news is that we get to share not only your journey through the tough times, but the good that you make of it, and that's a real gift, honey, and I want to thank you for that.
Thank you.
And your newest single, Homeless Heart, right?
Mm-hmm.
And that is, we're going to give those to everybody in the audience. I think they're all going home with those. And you guys can look for Jennette on Nickelodeon's iCarly. If you've got kids, really tune in. It's really a joy to watch. And Homeless Heart is available for downloads now.
Mm-hmm.
So you can go on the computer and get it too if you'd like. Thanks for tuning in. And you were just so, you did a great job. Thank you so much.